So if you're asking yourself, Declan, why you sat outside your neighbour's garage doing this month's exhibition chemistry, then that has to be a good sign, because at some point in the future, we've forgotten why at the beginning of 2020 everybody had to stay at home. Luckily, exhibition chemistry must go on, so of course I've got something for you that's simple enough that I can even perform it here. So let's get into it. What we're going to be looking at this month is the reaction of sucrose and sodium hydrogen carbonate as it begins to thermally decompose and combust. And that's going to produce for us a really cool kind of soda snake effect. Now, in order to do this, you either need some sucrose mixture with some sodium hydrogen carbonate, 4-to-1 ratio of the sugar to the bicarb, or you can actually use some of these sweets if you have them available where you are. These are Swizz or Matlow fizzers. I've also got some love hearts here. The crucial thing to be looking out for in the ingredients is the mixture of sucrose and sodium hydrogen carbonate as opposed to magnesium carbonate. Sometimes they're called like sort of fizzy sweets. And a few of these will also do the same trick. Hats off to I Teach Boys on Twitter. I saw you guys did this quite successfully in the run-up to Valentine's Day this year. So I thought I'd give that one a go as well. So all you need is some sand to set up your mixture in. Okay, make yourself a little well that you can pop your mixture into. It doesn't need to be too deep because actually you do need a little bit of oxygen to get access there to initiate the combustion as well. And I'm going to just fill my well with my 4 grams of sugar and my bicarb mix. And for comparison as well, we can see what happens with the fizzers or the love hearts. Okay, 3 or 4 of these is plenty. Any more than that, and actually you find that the ones on the bottom don't actually react anyway. Then what you're going to want to do is just a couple of mil of ethanol around the base in order to actually initiate the reaction. Of course, as soon as you expose this to a naked flame, you want to make sure that you're not actually going to try and reignite this, okay? So don't forget that ethanol burns with quite a poorly coloured flame, so you don't want to actually be tempted to pour ethanol back onto the mixture after you've tried to initiate the reaction. So if it doesn't work, first of all, do make sure that you stand back and don't pour extra ethanol on top. Just enough to moisten it around the outside here. Once the sugar gets going, the reaction will continue quite nicely. So let's have a look and see what these fellas do. There you have it. A demonstration so simple, it's even immune from the ravages of COVID-19. So if you get the chance ever to get back into the lab, and hopefully you will do, good luck giving it a try and enjoy it with these students.